Hello and welcome to the next edition of Hit and Run Fishing. I hope to show you some fish tonight, so like and subscribe if you haven't done already. I'm rock fishing in Dorset somewhere, that's all you're going to know. I'm fishing an ebbing tide. It's not flat, there's a bit of a swell rolling. But yeah, I'm hoping for an undulate ray, maybe a bass, possibly a pollock on the lure rod in a minute. Let's see what happens. I had a nice little knock just now on a first cast, and I had the evilest creature in the sea, most angry at least, the velvet swimmer on my line. There he is. They're so angry themselves, these are. Angry, red-eyed, vicious. Look, he's trying to bite me hook off. But beautiful nonetheless. He's lost the leg. Attacked by something probably. Hey, let's put him back. Well, there you go, a little lull in the bite. So we only had one little strap eel so far, but it's not even dark yet. It's a bonus. Anyway, for the evening, I'm fishing with squid and sand eel from Riot Baits. Squid and Riot Baits, sand eels from Weymouth Angling Centre. Yeah, lovely little eels. Anyway, I'm doing little packages like this. Two sand eel, two eels, back to back, wrapped in squid on a 6-0 on this rig. This is a 100-pound Robex 10X. The figure of eight at this end is a bit different than usual. It's a running ledger. So my bait clip, right on bottom clip, on the top end I've got a Gemini big bait clip and a 300-pound swivel. Clips up, bog standard clip down. The only difference a bit is it's got a rod bottom. There it is. Whew. Hopefully find a ray with that one. That's on one rod, and the other rod, even more like me. There's a lot of flies down here, though. It's just bog standard pulley rig. It's a bit long, don't know why I've got this one so long, but I've been early in the morning and very drunk at night. Right, I'd love a squid on this one. Yeah. It is now, I don't know what the time is. It's about 9 o'clock, I think, 9:30, 9. I've been getting bites and knocks every cast. So, see how we go. Let's try my other rod. Lost everything on that one. Let's try the other one. Oops. God, they're just attacking me. Flies everywhere. Didn't realise I'd film then. Look, big, whole squid, 6-0. There we go. Just trim that bit off the top. Let some more stink out so get some full flies on me. Horrible little buggers. Right, there we go. Whole squid, done. God, I feel like a fucking camel. Right, quick demo of my rig. Rotten the up and over this time. I'll take my rod and bottom. Should really have headlamp on, it's actually darker than what the screen shows. Anyway. 3 turn blood knot, so that's quite weak. Trim it off, and I get past the flies. They're in my hair, in my ears, in my nose. I'm going to set fire to an old lobster pot that's behind me in a minute and try and get rid of them. Then the wires are led in a bit. Still using up these olive leads I bought from Simon Morgan on Facebook. Good leads. I do prefer an Airmix on Chesil. I'm fishing on the sand here. I don't seem to be gripping as well as I was hoping. There's quite a lot of tide on here. But whatever. Ain't doing too bad. Right, rotten bomb, give it a spin. I actually thought it was raining just now, but it wasn't, there's flies on me. Right, set the rotten bomb, done. And the rotten bomb goes down the figure of eight with a bead, about a 6 foot snood, with a single 6-0 on it. And a knee. 6-0 must have big gun. Lovely hooks. That's going to get a double sand eel. Step to another bait. A double eel. Run up the squid. I might go a triple eel. Try and use my bait up quicker. I'm going to get my Gemini. Fly, fuck off. Set the heads and tails off. Head them and tail them. Let's get scent out, makes them go a bit easier. Right. I like these Gemini needles, the twin ones. I'll stick one eel one way on this one. I'll stick one eel the other way on this one, because that way the two, the thick and the thin ends, sort of line up in one sand eel sausage. So thick to thin, thin to thick. Yeah, thick to thin. So with a head end. Head end and the tail end, when they go together, they become a parallel sausage with the sand eel. Grab one of the squid. Keep the rods. And another set of pot boys pop up in front of me just now, and the tide's starting to drop down. It's very annoying. So I couldn't see them when I got here, which is why I chose this spot. Now the tide's dropped down a bit. Obviously their rope wasn't long enough. And the boy's now popped onto the surface. I just hope they don't come again. They shouldn't be. They're all watching the football. So I got double sand eel, lumber squid on the back, with a quick whip up, and find the hook. There it is, there it is. God, the flies. And I go down through the top, out the squid. I want my hook to sit about there. So I'm going in through the bait and out there, so the knot of the hook will sit back where I want it to. So in and out where I want it. In again. Out. And then pull it up tight, and then the knot will sit just where that line goes back in. That's why I like that long tag end on my bait, on my hook knots. So it acts like a bait stop, so it anchors all in place. My elastic will stop going back inside. There it is. Quick bit of thumb pressure, holds the hook nicely in line. Whip it up around the hook again. Fly in the ear, fly in the eye. I'm just crawling the flies, this is absolutely horrible. I'm actually leaving a minute because these things. Maybe that's why there's catch a fish here. Right. fly in my ear. Right. Pull that out. Done. Right. And it's that button. I'm going to go straight through on this rig now because some plum forgot his shock leader. Good 20 foot deep out there, I reckon. Right then guys, after lots and lots of missed bites, loads of missed bites, a couple of lost gears, I finally caught the culprit. Possibly the biggest spider crab I've caught. Oh well. He's barely hooked in the mouth though. He lines through his mouth. Hook round his leg. Lovely. Massive, massive. Hold my hand. There's the spider. There you go. It's a palm-sized spider crab for his body. Oh well, let's go chuck him back. That was a fairly uneventful night again. one strap eel, one spider crab, and one velvet swimmer. But hey ho, can't win them all. So you want to see more of this sort of thing, rock fishing in Dorset, as you walk back up a cliff, like and subscribe. Till next time, tight lines, boys.